Okay. I will present about the massive multi-node PostgreSQL BDR version in a retail system. And it is quite a big retail. It's hypermarket. If one of you wanted to ask something, just raise your hand. So we will discuss right away. Okay. My voice is good up to the back. Okay. Thank you. A little bit. I cannot speak more higher than this one. Mic. Can you use the mic?
This is for recording.
Okay. I will speak more louder. So I am Julyanto Sutandang. I am presenting Equinix Business Solution. It is an IT solution provider in Indonesia. We are doing very much in PostgreSQL services. And my company motto is an open source and open mind company. We should be open mind to use open source because very hard to approaching a client to use open source. There are so many factors that we already discussed. We deliver peace of mind. Our mostly client is the banks, payment gateway, retail system, retail companies. You can see in the screen, Mandiri Bank, BGB Bank is a big banks in Indonesia, and ADI, Danamon, Adira is a payment gateway, and many more. So one of my clients I will representing, I didn't say which one. So one of them is a retail company. This is also our clients. It's ExxonMobil, Slumbersea, Avaya. Not all of them using Postgres. We sell so many other products. One of them is Postgres. Okay. This is about a bit about our company. So we will tell about the background. The background is the big retail system has requirement about how to collect the transaction, the sales from the POS system all around Indonesia. We have about more than 3,400 POS. One store maybe can up to 60 POS. So it is a big challenge to collect the data real-time, in real-time manner. So before the data collection will be done every day, so it is not quite satisfied. We should change the system to make it the data can be collected in real-time manner, maybe every minute. And also the distribution, the new item. Somehow there are new item, new product, or maybe new promotion, or maybe new discount should be able to be distributed in a faster way. Before it is require maybe 1 or 2 days because we have 3,400 POS. It takes time. So by using later solution, we will able to distribute the new product, new promotion right away in seconds, about less than a minute. Okay, and the last capability that should have is the POS can have the capability to stay in service whether or not the network is good or not. So should be able to stand alone. Okay, this is the problem before. The LAN is very bad. So even it is a local network, the network is intermittent. You know the stores has many food and many mice. So yeah. And the one sometimes not really good, yeah. Infrastructure in Indonesia not, yeah. So we should have a system that can network problem proof that able to run without any hassle, even the network not really good. That's the aim. So this is the challenge. So there are 200 servers. Is 100 is a real server, another 100 is virtual servers, and one head office, and then 3,400 store POS machines. Okay, that's all the challenge. So how we solve the problem? We use, of course, BDR. But before BDR, we use the we change the POS. Before POS, using maybe one of you that already knew about Node.js, LevelDB, anything. It's a startup technology. It's not good for the POS because before they use LevelDB. LevelDB is quite heavy. Maybe a POS needs database, but in fact, it doesn't need actually. Just flat file database is good because the POS actually doesn't do transaction in terms of database transaction. POS only did single transaction, so doesn't need concurrency, so doesn't need database. Only flat file. If you use flat file, then you gain something more. If you want to update the flat file, you just send the difference and you patch it. This is what we did. Before the former vendor update the file about some 10 megabytes every night, so the POS should be run up and running. After we change, only using the difference, delta of difference, only couple of seconds. So we prepare the database in the store, actually in store, because from the store, replicate B directionally with the head office. And then after the store, we create the flat file for the product, promo, anything. And this flat file is keep in there as the historical data. And every changes, we will make a diff. And we get the difference file, we send to every terminals automatically. So the solution, we use the real time. It is synchronization, we use the BDR from database in the store to head office. And then, that's the solution. And the flat file, BDR. This is what we are talking, just talking about the terminal, just using the file, not using the any kind of database. Not even connecting to the server, they are running standalone. So when they are network problem, for example, the Ethernet being bitten by mice, that would be a problem. Okay, and this is in the store level. So we have one server containing one database, PostgreSQL, BDR, and connecting to many POS. And this server we already implement about, actually we are ourselves implement in one or maybe 10 stores. And when we come to the client again, we saw about 200 of BDR. BDR is maintained by second quadrant. It is a multi-master replication. Why we need multi-master replication? Because we need both ways, from the head office to the store, and then from store to the head office. So we cannot rely on single replication. We use multi-master replications. So from the head office, we update the promotion, the product, the price, and from the store, we update the sellers. So these sellers from the store, from the terminal, goes to the head office every second. every second. So the the CIO, the owner of the company, can see the sales every minute in their cell phone. That's the beauty of technology. I will show you the picture later. Okay. So BDR is the solution to maintain the infrastructure from the store to the head office using multi-master replication. BDR using PG logical, it is logical replication. So if you want to see the production level of multi-master replication, this is it. If you want to discuss, maybe we can discuss. So the BDR become the infrastructure. It is 200 more clusters. So one store and one database in the S office, it's one cluster. So there are 200 stores. So there are 200 databases in the head office in single instance. Maybe you can use single instance or two instance. So there are 200 databases, exactly the same with 200 databases in the store. So there are 200 clusters. Okay. It's all across Indonesia. Okay. This is the most important thing that I am talking in this event. How we manage multi-master replications in a production level in use in the retail system all around Indonesia. It's running right now, 200 databases and giving you the transactions, the sales transaction report to the head office every time. So the beauty of the BDR is you can, BDR is quite, network problem proof. So if there are problem of networks, I will show you. Like this, we have the online monitoring system. So when the network problem, they are black in the box, in the widget, means there is no connection. When is the connection back live again, become green, and also the database synchronized. We have tested a couple of hours, but maybe up to, if I'm not mistaken, 12 hours, there's no connection. After the connection back alive again, it will continue. So quite tough. So this monitor give you the network check, healthy check, and also give you the status of the updates. Because it is too small. So there is a number of store, and then the hash, this is updates of the file from head office, sorry, from store to the its terminal. This is also the monitoring system of the application. The application gives you the data of status of the healthy of the system. So this one, you can see the price here means the omset of its store. I cannot show it to you, so I have to make it black like that. So actually we can do without multi-master replication. We can create web services. We can make real-time web services whatsoever. But it takes a lot of effort to maintain also, because web services we should able to monitor whether it's run or not, synchronous or not, etc. By using the BDR, you gain something more better, because it's already done in the BDR. What you should do is to check to monitor the replication status. Any question?
You have no conflict in data, right? Because
yeah,
straightforward.
Yes. The beauty of this implementation, we access different tables, so there's no potential of deadlocks. Yeah. So this one is following the distributed databases. Multi-master databases actually intended, the best implementation is for distributed databases. So there's no potential conflicts. When head office update the data, they use this table and that table. The sellers use another table, so there's no potential conflict. Any other? Yes?
Do we have some kind of metadata table where we can see like how much data is in sync and how much it's not in sync? Like for example, like, there is a network resolution, and then like once the network is restored, I want to know that like how much data is in sync from one to another.
Okay. The replication of the multi-master replication using the sequence. So what we did, what we need to do is to check the sequence. If the sequence is running well, so there are also in PG status, there is a flag. The flag and the sequence is the two things that we check to ensure the status of application is in a good way, in a good condition.
That just shows the status.
Yes.
Sync or not.
We don't have any others.
Would you like to see that how much the sync is done and how much more the sync has to be?
Yeah. Anyway, we don't have it. We don't have it. You can. I think you can check that from the logical replication flow. Maybe you can see whether the how many difference it is from the head office to the stores. But for us, I think because replication should be have the same status, right? So the main that we check, that we monitor is the sequence, whether the sequence is the same between in the head office and in the store. We also did some second check with using the query. We sometimes doing like something like count the table, yeah. But it's more longer.
Like, do you have any kind of a data which says that like it took this much time to sync my database from node A to node B? Like,
yeah.
How much of transaction per sync? A kind of facts that you can share with.
Yeah, facts. Yeah, actually, somehow the retail user send the updates in bulk updates, so that become problem because the network only 1 megabits per store. So when you send the very huge amount of data from head office to the store, it will block the connection, and eventually database also not running stable. In some cases when maybe the connection is broken or maybe synchronization is broken, we can do something like resynchronize, rebuild the nodes. So one cluster consists of nodes. There are master nodes and there is child nodes. So we rebuild the child nodes to resynchronize to the master. That's sometimes that we should do.
Okay, just last question.
Yes.
Can there be a scenario that one table is in sync and the other table is not in sync? Like, let's say I have table A and table B.
No, the synchronization is done in the, not in database. The table way.
Yeah, it is done in the database level.
The database level.
Yeah. But let's say that there is a scenario where one of the tables is not in sync.
Yeah.
So is there a way we can detect that, or like kind of a monitoring for like at the table?
I'm not sure we can detect which table is synced or not synced, because the replication is done in the database level. So as long as the synchronization has a same sequence, it is done. But we cannot determine whether the table is in sync and another table is not in sync.
There's no
yeah, we don't have that kind of check per table basis. We check per database basis. Yeah. Any other questions? Okay, this is the mobile view of the monitoring. So the monitoring actually is a simple application. So why this monitoring can be a good monitoring, because show you real-time data. How they can show you real-time data? Because of BDR. So because BDR, the beauty of BDR, so we have no hassle in communication data from head office to the store, yeah. The store in Indonesia is, you know, many cities, and also some of the cities in the very far away to the sea. So, having actually we have not really good network communications. So that's the fact that we face. But using BDR, we can use the BDR on top of that kind of infrastructure. So there's another warning, or maybe downside of the BDR. Not all object is replicated. It's sequence and non-deterministic function, any non-database object. So role you should create in both databases. So the conclusion is BDR is a good solution for the retail for the retail system which has multiple or many stores. It can reduce the overhead in data communication, data synchronization, and data integrity. BDR with its logical replication completes both ways using the multi-master topology. Yeah, it ensures the data availability and has strong tolerance to the network latency and intermittent network problems, actually. So, any question? Yeah?
So, you said about 200 nodes, right?
Sorry?
200 nodes is what you mentioned, right?
200 databases, 200 nodes.
So, let's say that how many nodes do you have in your master system?
200.
Head office has how many nodes?
200 database.
So, when you're talking about
nodes? One instance.
So, if that instance goes down, then you don't have any other backup?
We can back up the instance, right?
Okay, so if that instance goes down, we have a backup which automatically fails over to that, and then...
No, you should, fail over all of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is there a scenario where your nodes in the stores try to update a table in the master simultaneously? So is there a scenario where there can be a conflict between two masters updating the same table at the same time?
Conflict between two masters?
Yep.
Because this master have a different site with another master. I don't think there's any potential conflict.
My question is, let's say that you have two nodes at the stores, two different stores trying to update a table, a single table at the same time.
No, there's no way. Because feature logical done in the logical database. So there's no potential conflict.
Do you take care of conflict resolution, like saying that, if there's a bidirectional replication?
No, we don't take care of conflict resolution because it's already done in BDR. Yeah, BDR has a single connection for a single database. So there's no, so in the database, in the Postgres in the Postgres terminology about databases, single databases is independent than the others. Okay, so BDR run in the database based communications. So there's no conflict. There's no potential conflict. Any other questions? Yes.
You mentioned when the network was strong,
yes,
the QoS can still function.
Oh yeah.
So when the network goes up, you mean in the QoS application, whenever the network goes up, you run some tasks to synchronize.
Yeah, actually the POS system running in using the flat file and creating flat file also per transaction, one file. You know, and you can, like for example, you have a struct when you buy groceries, and that struct is one file. So if there's a get, it there's problem in network, get offline. So there are many files inside the POS actually, okay? And then there's the agent inside the POS and going, trying to connect to the servers every time, and when the server is up again, or maybe the network become online, so the file is sending to the store servers automatically, right away. After that, from store, the file is inserted into the databases. Okay, that's also automatically, even basis. And then the database from the store will automatically replicate to the head office. And then the database in head office automatically send data with the store, right? So we can show in the monitoring system, real time. So the owner of this company can see the transaction, the offset, the sellers every time. Real time, using his mobile.
So is there any chances that the data is not synced?
Sorry?
The data is not synced in the stores or the headquarters.
What is the question?
Is there any chances that the data is not
synced? Is there any chances that the data is not synced? The data is not synced, yeah, there's a possibility in some of the step, like for example the BDR, yeah. And then from the store to the POS. But we have a check every time. In every point, well, for example, BDR will ensure you the data is synchronized when the sequence is the same. There's a capability of that. Okay, so when the BDR connection is healthy, so you can ensure this will be good. Okay, and then from the store to from the terminal to the store, it's a automatic. Something like copy file, we use SSH automatically. So when we can check how many file in the post and how many file in the store, and we send to the S office, we have heartbeats in every point. In terminal to store, there is heartbeats. Store to the S office, there is heartbeat. And this heartbeat send the status. So this status goes to the monitoring system. So we can check through this monitoring system whether the connection is good or the data is good, synchronized or not. We check there. Yes?
Why not use BDR from the POS to the store?
No, we don't use database at all in POS. Why use BDR?
Because they didn't write your own flat file synchronization routines, right?
No, POS is only two processor, atom processor. It's very small computer.
I see.
Yeah. This POS is a very small POS. So, we don't really need.
So cannot run. It doesn't run on this hardware. You're saying, is that? Mean?
No.
Will not run on this kind of hardware.
No. POS cannot handle browser. We use a browser-based application, right? Cannot handle the Node.js server and the BDR altogether. But if you use only the browser Firefox and the Node.js server in a flat file, it's very very light. No problem. So we. Before, the POS using LevelDB. You know LevelDB?
Yes.
Something like database, right?
Yes.
It's very heavy.
It's a key value store, I guess.
Yeah, key value store and very heavy. You don't need even key value store. You just need flat file. Key value store is just into the flat file. it is done all of them in the JavaScript. So, yeah, that's the way. So you don't need any kind of database because it's very heavy.
So I'm just thinking of two different synchronization methods, one from flat files to your store and then from your store to headquarter office. It's two different methods, actually.
Not two different methods. I just telling the complete solution. I mean, indeed that the terminal, we don't talk about database.
Sure.
We talk about the terminal can be operational without any kind of network problem.
Sure.
Yeah, that's different story, actually. But I'll tell you a complete solution.
The so you have some custom means to move the flat files, right? You have some custom code.
Yeah, we call it agent. The agent is in the terminal, also the agent in the store. This agent maintaining the heartbeats, maintaining the file transfer, maintaining the synchronization, also maintaining the updates. We can update the applications in the terminal right away because we use Git. If there's an update from the developer, we send to the repo. And this repo will distribute to all of the terminal. And right away, when there's changes, the agent get the changes. If the cashier press print, after print, it's a restart. And this is new facility come. It is very smooth for a versioning update. We use Git also.
So this agent is written by your...
Yeah, the agent is customized. It's a C application. Yeah. Yeah, this is the agent is somebody who take care of us and to glue all together. Yeah, we use C because it's very small server. So cannot use any other vendor. Okay, maybe you want to ask? Okay. Anybody? Maybe. Thank you very much for the questions. If you have any kind of problem and wanted to discuss more further, you can reach me by mail me. My email is, can I see, write my email? I forgot to write. So I will write here. So it is reconnecting. Oops, sorry. My email is Julyanto. @equinix.id.
Sure. Make sure that when you upload your slides, you upload or send your final slides to me.
Yeah.
Send them with your email ID.
Yes.
And when I upload them on SlideShare, you all will have access to these slides. PG Day Asia is an official handle for Postgres community in Asia to post all our slides over there. So the conference we had yesterday and our FOSSASIA track today, all the presentations are going to be uploaded to that SlideShare account or SlideShare handle. You will have access to that. Do follow us on Twitter and Facebook as well. We will keep posting about all these slides and everything and pictures of yourselves sleeping and awake. on our Twitter handle and Facebook page. Now is the time to go downstairs for getting better pictures clicked. FOSSASIA is conducting a photo session, so you will be part of a very large group. So come downstairs.
Can I have a photo session first? I want to copycat the dream. Okay. Wait a minute. I'm